Thank you. first I wanted to thank everyone for coming. We had imagined, there it is. We had imagined this as kind of a refuge from winter's night, this show. And I think it's turning out that way. It was super rainy, at least when I went out for dinner. And so it's really exciting to see everyone having made it in from the cold. And hopefully this show will kind of take care of all of us. I think it's all music and art that that remembers the night and the cold outside, and also celebrates being here together in this space with warmth and light. So I'm really excited to share it with you. The next piece is something that I wrote, and it's music that's drawn from a much larger project that I've been working on for the last 6.5 years with my collaborator, Thomas Barcher, who's over there. And Thomas. The larger piece is called History of Life, and it imagines that the oral tradition that created the Odyssey, where the person that we know in quotes as Homer had passed down this story through generations of Odysseus returning home. This piece imagines that that tradition had not ended in the ancient Mediterranean, but actually continued every night in pubs and by the seaside for the last 2,700 years and has arrived here in all sorts of strange forms and has picked up other stories and bits of music and legends along the way. And one of the other stories it's picked up is the voyage of Charles Darwin on the Beagle, as Darwin, almost against his will, discovers the vastness of life. And that's what this scene is that we're about to hear. The music is drawn from imagining this moment where you try and think about just how long this earth has existed. It's not really possible. We can remember that the Cambrian explosion was 539 million years ago, but that doesn't really mean anything to the way that we think about it. So it's something that music has the potential to kind of create that magic that's in the missing space from what we can't understand. And something that's really fascinating to me of trying to imagine that unimaginable thing of what if you could actually picture in your head what it means for 539 million years on this planet to have passed, with every one of those seconds containing all of the life on this planet with infinite yearning and eating and love and mistakes and heliotropes turning towards the sun. That consists of every second of experience in 539 million years. And so this piece is a kind of musical space for us to enter into, picturing that truly play out in front of us in reverse and watching the building disappear instantly and New York to turn back into marshland and be overtaken by the sea and the ocean to move in and out 1,000 times and the dinosaurs to return and the asteroid to unhit the earth and et cetera, et cetera. So that's what we'll be doing. I don't know if we're ready and I can stop talking. But thank you so much for coming, and I'll see you at the after show, after party. We've got hot chocolate and hot cider, which is gonna be really nice.
Thank you. I was so ready to play this piece because I'm so excited for you to hear it. But I'm also really excited for you to meet the maker of this piece. My name's David. Thank you again for being here. Thanks for the reminder, Dylan. So everybody, please welcome Lila Meretzky.
Can you hear me? Yes, okay. I really can't overstate how glad I am to see each and every one of you here. I'm gonna try to keep this brief and give you a little bit of context for what you're about to hear. So, Anna Margolin, this poet whose text I have set, was born as Rosa Lebensboim in 1887 in what is now Belarus. And it was a time of great upheaval, migration, modernization in European Jewish life. She received a secular education, which was unusual at the time, and traveled widely, living and working for times in London, Paris, Warsaw, Odessa, which is the title of one of the poems, and Palestine, where she left behind her infant son and first husband, of whom she reportedly never spoke again after that time. And, you know, but before the sort of middle of the 19th century and beginning of the 20th century, there wasn't really a Yiddish literary tradition. It was the vernacular language. Much of the culture hadn't been written down, but suddenly there was this enormous flourishing of plays, poetry, stories, and novels. And, you know, during this flourishing, being a woman, she also, already part of this kind of marginal literary community, she experienced a lot of exclusion from the mainstream within Yiddish literary traditions. But perhaps this lack of historical precedent and also personal exclusion led her to forge her own path that maybe wasn't so bogged down by orthodoxy around form and the content of what she was writing. And her work is very fluid, and I've tried to respond to that with the music. You can read a little bit more about that in the program notes. But I love how this response has also continued with the projections. I've commissioned the brilliant projection designer, Camilla Tassi, to take some art that I made and kind of add another layer of animation and video footage, which you'll see projected behind during the course of the piece, that will sort of bring the words closer to all of us. When I came across your poetry in 2018 for the first time, I was really struck by these kind of fantastical imageries contrasted with these really heavy-hitting punchlines about you know, these kinds of very lucid truths that sort of emerge from these dream worlds. And these are things that I imagine it would have been really hard to say as a woman at the time, kind of laying bare her interiority and her dissatisfaction with domestic life. You know, I want to say something about the second to last poem, which was the very first music that I composed of this piece, which is called The Golden Peacock. And in Yiddish folkloric tradition, the golden peacock is a symbol, or it's this kind of magical creature and a symbol of communication across borders, across time, sort of carrying messages that really could otherwise never be said. And I love this image for a lot of reasons. It's one of, you know, this kind of impossible communication is one of the things that we say that music does, you know, when words fail and all that. And, you know, for me, as somebody who's living in the 21st century, who is studying but doesn't speak Yiddish, and I'm trying to respond to these words written 100 years ago, it's something that I try to keep in mind when I'm having a conversation with Margolin, and it's kind of unfair to me because it's not really a conversation. She can't talk back. But in this, my often changing and occasionally fraught, especially right now, relationship with my, you know, religious and cultural background, this communion with the past has been really comforting. And I think it's also important not to assume that what Margolin left behind and what I've arranged into this piece actually tells us anything about her as a person, that the story that emerges here is hers or that it's mine. It's this other third thing that I'm still unraveling that we made in collaboration. You know, and this unknowability of other people is definitely a theme in this poetry. You know, despite Margolin's unknowability, I think she also has kind of a kinship in her subjects that we can all find, dealing with these themes of personal isolation, mortality, and a desire to feel connected with nature. You know, what I take from her work is these boundaries that separate people and make it hard to talk, or separate people from nature or that cleave the earth. They're real, and what they do to us is very real, but they're also kind of imaginary as these beautiful images that Margolin has dreamed up. So thank you all for being here. Thank you to Roulette and the technical team, these amazing musicians, our fierce soloists, Lucy and Milena, Contemporaneous leadership, Dylan and David. This is Songs at Night. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Viele zählich kein Konvei tun. Konvei tun, Konvei tun. Konvei. was du schmeichelst, mit und Feul. Oh, kenn ich das Zucken von dein treurigen Gesang. Maske, das Pudding von Mann, geht mir noch wie ein Klole. Spann, noch, spann. Und der Kribbel hängt mir entgegen, gleb ich jon lang. Sei Meukel mir, Brude, was gleich ist mein Gang. Weiten bin ich zugeschmitt mit Käten. Oh, Stille! Thank you. sich gebeugen. Zärtlicher meiner, ihr, schlaf ein, schlaf ein. es Regen heint. Alle stumme Sachen es rinnt wie toi das bläue flüstern von schlanken Wolken Heuche kluge Wörter räuschen in die Kräunen von die Hämmer von die alte gewaltige Statens stehen. Shikes.